variation from inter-system point of view. And last thing is actually variation from the regulation and harmonization point of view. In stage one, the use case analysis, technical analysis were done in order to have the technical characteristics of the frequency ranges from 6 to 30 gigahertz, from 30 to 60 gigahertz, and the 60 to 100 gigahertz respectively. In stage two, each frequency band was evaluated for the 5G deployment while considering the incumbent radio systems already deployed in Japan on the frequency band. So this stage resulted in a list of the preferred frequency band. The 11 candidate band of the WRC 19 agenda item 1.13 and 27.5 to 29.5 GHz, which are mentioned in the Japanese government report, Radio Policy 2020, as the candidate band for the 5G are in the scope in this stage two discussion. So this is the 11 the candidate bands to be discussed within the WRC 19 agenda item 1.13. This shows the result of the stage two analysis on frequency band above 6 GHz with sharing the possibility with IMT. So the I'm sorry, I missed the meaning of the 1, 2, 3 the evaluation. So far the 1 is the more difficult or extremely difficult. Two is difficult, but could be okay, but almost difficult. Three is the possible to the share. Then number four is the candidate part. So from we discussed further the within not only the 11 the candidate band to be discussed within the WRT, but includes these 28 gigahertz. So far, 24.25 to 24.75, and also the 42.5 to 43.5 are very difficult to share with IMT, because this one is totally used with radio science. I think that in Indonesia as well, I think. This is some the research one for the radio astronomy or the some the institutional the research. And also the 24, lower band. Lower band is the use for the fixed wireless system, the point to point or the multi point the distribution. And the another band could be okay. So far, we would like to discuss further. From the global harmonization point. So stage three evaluation, the band list, after the evaluation process in stage two, are being further evaluated in consideration of the views, in consideration of the view from other countries and the region and spectrum harmonization. Stage 3 will result in other list of the preferred frequency bands, which are potentially a subset of the stage 2 output. So this is the investigation for the stage 3. This is a stage 2 analysis, but the other side is that the other countries, US, Europe, the Korea, China situation. So far, after the analytical situation with the other country, other region, the situation, then we consider our candidate the frequency band for 5G. Through three stages evaluation process, we selected five candidate bands above 6 GHz for 5G. These bands are not the conclusion in the government level. However, we believe a part of or whole of the frequency bands are preferred for the initial use for the 5G spectra. We are interested in the range of both the 28 GHz and 26 GHz, which is the identified as a 5G pioneer band in Europe. As you know, well, that the sub-band is that the pioneer band, called pioneer band in Europe, 26 GHz is a candidate band for the 5G in Europe. But in Japan, US, and Korea, almost another candidate band for the 5G. We hold this band is the frontier band. 28 GHz, the initial discussion, we established the 28 GHz, the frontier workshop. It's a kind of the informal discussion, the workshop. But I think that in the near future, we would like to formally establish the 28 GHz workshop. So yesterday, I also asked that the Telecom University colleague to join the 28 GHz the frontier workshop to join that the discuss further, because that the Indonesia also the 28 GHz will be used for the 5G. So far, I think that the colleague in Indonesia should be joined the 28 GHz discussion. So, this is the stage 3 result. We had five candidate ranges, but mainly we focusing on the start point is the 28 GHz. However, after then, we would like to extend other band. This is our phased approach. This is a more concrete idea almost discussed within the government level. So below 6 GHz, government already decided the 3.6 to the 4.2 GHz and 4.4 to the 4.9 GHz should be allocated to the 5G use. So allocation by the end of the Japanese fiscal year this year, so far, the end of the March next year. So the bandwidth, total bandwidth is at the 500 MHz within below 6 GHz. In case of the above 6 GHz, the start point is this band, 27.5 to the 29.5 GHz. The maximum allocation is 2 GHz.